Welcome to Up, Up, Down, Down. I'm your host, Austin Creed, just almost dropped the controller. And we got a special guest today. Tell them who you are and what you do.
Hey, everybody. I'm AJ Kirsch, and I am the voice and mocap body for Buzz, a.k.a. my player in WWE 2K. Have we started already?
No.
WWE 2K19. Okay.
Can you tell them, too?
Yeah, hey, buddy.
Wait, I'm introducing myself?
Yeah.
I am the Angel of Flight, Mike Matthews, and I'm just happy to be here, and I'm just going to be here in the background doing a lot of this. And...
Perfect.
That's the strap.
Perfect. And that's exactly what we like here on Up, Up, Down, Down. We like a lot of randomness. We like a lot of things to be fresh.
We'll figure it out as we
fun.
Go.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So we'll be playing Separation Anxiety, Spider-Man Venom from Super Nintendo.
Venom!
So
Venom! Never knew what hit him.
Solid.
Like so, I said, figuring it out as we go.
One of us will be Spider-Man, one of us will be Venom. I don't know.
I hope to be Venom because Venom's actually my all-time favorite comic book character.
Really?
All-time favorite.
Well,
yeah.
If I'm Venom, we can switch.
Okay, that's fine. Cool, I appreciate that.
I love Venom, too. Yep, I'm Venom.
Yep, okay, here we go.
All right, perfect.
Wow.
I'll be Spidey.
Venom. All right, now, I've never played this before, so
play
I'm just going to...
No.
Kruger.
Okay, so speaking of that Venom song,
yeah.
So do you follow Eminem?
A little bit, yeah. Most recent thing I've heard of his is Killshot, where he verbally eviscerated Machine Gun Kelly.
Okay, so who do you think won that battle? Because I assume you heard Machine Gun Kelly's as well?
All I heard was your beard is weird, and then I shut it off, and I was like, it's over. It's like, go back to the kiddies table, man. Your beard is weird. Like, that's how you come out of the gate? Get out of here.
Okay, so I've had this discussion with a bunch of different people.
Okay.
And like, I love Eminem. And
sure.
I think he's the greatest, and like his battle rap stuff is so nasty. But, and I think for me, it's like, I feel like Eminem won,
yeah.
But Machine Gun Kelly's beat is so nasty.
The beat made it.
The beat's so nasty.
How much of that credit goes to the Machine Gun Kelly though? Does he produce his own stuff?
I have no idea.
Okay.
I have no idea.
But you're just sitting there going, oh my God, this might be better. And you can't believe yourself saying
yeah,
it.
Yeah.
But you're like, oh my God.
Yeah. But then is it because like, because Eminem's isn't a song, it's like a diss track.
Right.
And
yeah.
Kelly's is like a song.
Yeah, it just feels like Eminem put more into like freestyling, and that's probably why he got more props for it.
Yeah.
The Machine Gun putting together a great song, actually. I
was like, hell of a song.
I need to go back and listen
to it.
When
I'm at the gym, I'm gonna listen to it.
Yeah,
you know,
I didn't.
I'm like, yes.
I didn't know that he could do that. So I was like, okay, this is. Give him some clout, okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I guess I do need to give it a chance, but as soon as I heard
just a little bit.
Yeah, I mean, I shut it off way earlier than I should have, but I heard your beard is weird, and immediately, and then it cracked me up, because when I heard Killshot, Eminem's making fun of that line in the first, like, 5 seconds of that song, and I'm just like, oh, it's already over.
So nasty.
Yeah.
What'd
you think of the movie, Venom?
I still haven't seen it.
Oh, okay.
I still haven't seen it. I haven't been able to go to the movies in a while.
Yeah.
A lot of times I'll want to see a movie, and then, you know, you just kind of forget.
Yeah.
So, like, the last thing I saw was Creed, because, like, I'm very attached to the whole, like, Rocky franchise.
Right.
So, like, I forced myself. I was like, I'm going. I have to go. So, but there's a bunch of stuff that I haven't seen, like, especially Venom.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm kind of the same way. Like, I pass by a movie theater every time I go to the gym, and it's like I see the marquee with all the stuff, and it's like, I still want to see Creed. I hear A Star Is Born is really good.
Yeah.
And there's some.
What'd you laugh?
No,
that's what I hear.
No, the old one's amazing. Christopherson's actually. My mom loves that movie.
It's a remake. So one of the things that you have done, like
yes.
You said, you were involved in like doing all the My Career stuff for the WWE 2K game. How did you come across that?
So it actually all circles back to wrestling.
Yeah.
Like I was an independent worker from like 2005 until 2012, 2013 when I started to kind of direct my focus towards hosting, ring announcing, and commentary.
Yep.
And I was also on the 2011 season of Tough Enough, which
yes.
is why if some people were like, I don't know why that guy looks
yeah.
familiar. That is why. Oh, I'm dead.
Oh, no.
No.
Just reset it.
Okay, cool.
We just reset it, then we start the story back.
But anyway, to answer your original question,
yes.
So I made it 8 out of 10 episodes, didn't get signed, but of course... watching previous seasons, it's like not everybody who wins sticks around, and not everybody who loses, it's not the end for them.
Yeah.
So I was like, okay, how do I make myself as valuable and attractive a commodity to WWE as possible?
Mm-hmm.
And they always appreciate it when their talent can reach out, or branch out rather, into other avenues of entertainment, whether
yeah.
it's TV or movies, or, you know, they want to be able to go on talk shows, all that stuff.
Mm-hmm.
So I was like, all right, I'm going to see if I can sign with the local agency in the San Francisco Bay Area, which is where I'm at, and try to do commercials or TV shows
yeah.
or whatever. And you know, it took a while to get going, but between hosting, ring announcing, and doing commentary at wrestling shows and acting, I'm able to make a full-time living.
Yeah, that's
which
awesome.
Is, thank you. Awesome. I'm really, really happy about that. So this agency, they hook me up on auditions for anything. Voiceovers, yeah. Television, movies, like all kinds of stuff. And they came to me with an audition for... they don't want me to reveal the code name of the project, so I won't. But there was the synopsis of the role was an independent wrestler who's been bouncing around the scene for a little while gets a tryout with WWE, and in my head I'm like, how many talent do they have that this is their story? I'm like, this is me. Like, I am made for this role.
Yeah.
So I went in and read for it, and I felt good about it, but the thing I've learned about auditions is that you could feel like you had the best audition in the world and never hear from them again.
Yeah.
And you could feel like and have, like, just case in point, we're tough enough. Yeah. I thought it was over, and they're like, nah, we like him. That's what we're looking for. Yeah. But the person that I read the audition, the casting person, they thought I had a good read. I felt good about it. And about a week later, I got an email from someone at 2K saying, hey, we loved your audition. We would like to offer you the role, but code word is not actually code, or code word was the working title for my career in WWE 2K19. Oh, okay. So I didn't even know I was auditioning for that when I was. And then I got it, and I remember I was in the car at a stoplight reading emails, and I immediately fired up AC/DC and started pumping play. I was just so stoked.
Yes, I did it.
I did it. If, like, full circle, because I grew up a gamer. Like, I was a gamer before I was a wrestling fan.
Yeah.
And then just having played, God, so many hundreds of hours with Warzone and Attitude and No Mercy.
Oh, you played Warzone?
Oh, yeah. Oh, I'm sorry. Wait, hey, at the time, I was like, because the one before that was like WrestleMania the arcade game, which was...
Dude, you didn't like WrestleMania the arcade game?
I mean, it was Undertaker beating people with tombstones. Actual tombstones.
Like, Yokozuna just like throwing the hammer or whatever.
Right.
Oh.
Doink with his giant mallet and... I don't even know what Shawn Michaels was like.
He threw the hearts.
Oh, that's right. He threw the broken hearts.
Did he have a baseball
bat, too? Did he have a... Oh, somebody had a baseball. Yeah. That may have been Razor Ramon, I think. Mm. I think Scott Hall had
what a game.
Right. I mean, we still remember it, so they were doing something right. But I was stoked when Acclaim got the rights to WWE, because it was... Yeah, Warzone, and then Attitude, and then... Holy God. Thank God THQ got a hold of
it,
because I was a WWE guy growing up, but I was a WCW video game guy.
Oh my God,
because World Tour and Revenge were the best.
Revenge? Come on.
Right.
Such a good game.
And so then they got the WWE license. It was like, it just doesn't get any better. And for my money, like, as much as I am always going to be honored and thrilled to be a part of 2K19, nothing will ever replace No Mercy for me. No Mercy is the top of the mountain.
See, okay, so I had this argument with people, too. So I always was bigger on WrestleMania 2000.
So was I.
Really?
Yeah. Why? I'm about to say, what about WrestleMania?
Ladder matches? Yeah. And I know. You could bust away the table and fight backstage. Like, I mean, I'd love to hear it.
I honestly don't have an argument for why. I had both of them, and I always played. When there was a choice to be made, I always played WrestleMania for whatever reason. I don't know if it was just because I was a big, like, mark for, like, the black and green. And, like, that actual pay-per-view was, like, so dope.
Yeah.
Because, like, you know how, since you guys are wrestlers, you understand when people say, like, oh, man, but, like, WrestleMania 2000 Triple H, oh, man.
Oh, God.
Like,
that's it. That's it.
Like, you understand.
Yeah.
So, the entrance and the different color lights, he's just, like, so jacked.
Yeah.
Like, for some reason, I always associated that with that video game, and it's, like...
That's as good as it gets?
Yeah. Yeah. Like, that's the epitome of, like, wrestling to me. Like,
it was the old song. It was that.
Oh, yeah.
One, two?
Yeah.
That thing, man.
What a jam.
Yeah. What a really jam. Seriously. I love the Motorhead version, but I'll cue that up every time in time. Don't even keep your finger off the switch.
Oh, my God.
At the gym, once in a while, it goes on. I'm not going to lie.
Yeah.
randomly, the Run DMC one will hit. I always forget, like, no one gives that one any love.
Yeah.
What
Although,
a song.
I have a question about that. Yeah. It's not Run DMC. It's just Run.
It's just Run.
There's no DMC. Why?
Aren't they always credited?
It's always credited as Run DMC. I don't see it as just Reverend Run. So maybe he helped write it or something, but, like,
maybe.
It's just Run. Mm. I love DMC. Like, I love, like, he even had a solo album come out. I don't even know how many years ago that I was like, oh, this is still pretty good. But yeah, there's just no DMC.
These are things we need to find out.
Right.
These are questions we need answers to.
Yeah, anybody out there know the answer to this, please put it in the comments below. Yes. I'm dying to know.
There's got to be a clause written when they first started that everything has got to be credited to Run DMC.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's technical.
It's kind of like how we do with New Day. Like, whenever we do anything, pretty much, it's like, no. We have to, if it's like pictures, like promos, whatever, like, no, it's all three of us.
It's always,
it's all three of us. Yeah, you will not separate us.
No, that's cool. That's cool.
Yeah, I even remember that specific. He's like, it's DJ Run, y'all, and this is how I get down. Generation X coming to your town. I'm like, where's DMC? DMC's
he's in the back, just like, I like wrestling too. Oh man. Okay, so when you're doing all the mocap and everything, also for the game, like, what was the craziest moment? Is there any like weird stories?
Well, you know what was really cool about that for me is that the guy who played Cole Quinn, which was like the kind of, I guess, supporting, like, Buzz's friend, like, coming up in training, is in real life one of the guys who at the time would just see at independent shows up and down the West Coast. And a funny way that kind of life imitating art, he is of Saudi descent.
Okay.
And so he was, I guess, already as a part of the PC database. And WWE got a hold of him. And he was actually, if you remember... I think it was Greatest Royal Rumble. Was that the first one? The first one they did in the Greatest Royal Rumble? This is Mansoor Al-Shehail, who cut that promo in the middle of the ring and shoved, I think it was Daivari.
Yeah.
And just, I mean, you could if you go back and watch it on the network, it's just totally took charge of that segment, and now he's a part of NXT.
Yeah.
And it was just so cool to share that experience with somebody I knew and enjoyed working with. You know, just putting this game together. And he is also, you know, a lifetime gamer and obviously a huge WWE fan, indie worker. So, and it's just so cool seeing him in NXT. And I don't know, like, what a hell of a year for him. And to be a part of it was really cool. But surreal is the term I keep going back to. Yeah. Like, just growing up a gamer, growing up a wrestling fan, like, I don't know how it gets any better. Yeah. But I'm going to find a way. Because for me, and I'm sure, you know, for anybody out there who's ever tried to chase down a dream or achieve a goal, it's like you have to keep finding ways to kind of surprise yourself.
Yeah.
You really don't know what you're capable of until you believe you can accomplish anything. Mm-hmm. Not to get super sentimental or anything, but...
Making it real.
Look where you're at right now.
I know! Look where you're at right now! Like, it's led me to up, up, down, down, which in itself is...
You know, we try to do some cool stuff every now and then.
Yeah.
Right before I got signed, I got to do mocap for WWE All-Stars.
Oh, yeah!
Which is like... if you don't know the game, it's like Blitz for wrestling.
I was going to say Def Jam Vendetta.
Yeah.
But like the wrestling, it was a wrestling.
Unbelievable game.
Yeah.
And I'm so mad that there's not another one and that the franchise didn't keep going. Because it was so good. Such a good like alternative, like non-wrestling simulator, which is a good like arcade wrestling game.
Right. Dude. That's so. I had no idea they even did mocap just because the moves themselves were just... ridiculous. Oh, yeah. So they were insane.
So they showed me, so I ended up actually doing Kofi's moves.
Oh, okay.
So I did Kofi's moves, and they do Trouble in Paradise, and then he puts it on like the Kofi model, and he goes, so this is you doing it. And it's like, okay, it looks cool. And he's like, this is what it's going to actually look like. And then it shoots him into like the sky, and he does four flips, and then comes down and kicks the guy in the head, and I was like, oh my God, this game's going to be awesome. It's losing my mind. People doing mocap, like if you've never done mocap, it is a crazy experience to be able to see like your movements, like while you're in the suit, on the computer, on the models and everything.
Did you ever catch yourself looking up at the monitor just like doing this
100%.
Thing? Yeah, all the time. 100%,
just moving in like blank space.
Yeah.
Okay, so since you did get that role, you have become a huge part of the WWE games now. The first time, like... were you able to tell your friends about it when you were doing it?
No. I mean, this is the type of thing that they swear you to absolute secrecy. Yeah. And it was to the point even that I didn't see any footage, any voiceovers, any rough cuts until the trailer dropped that everybody saw like a month before the game came out. So I'm just like, I can finally share it. I can finally talk about it. And of course, sitting on something like that for 6 months in itself is exhausting.
Yeah. And then your friends who like, you're super close, like, you wouldn't tell me this?
Right. I'm like, exactly. I'm like, I could get sued for millions if this got out. Like, I trust you, but not that much.
So when the trailer first dropped, like, did your phone blow up? Yeah.
Like, oh my God. Yeah. Is that, they're like, is that you? Yeah. I'm like, yeah, man.
And your Twitter mentioned, you're just like, all right, yeah.
I was watching that follower count go up and I was just like, this is good. This is real good. Here's a question for you. Your impression on the new Sonic movie posters.
So,
while we're on it.
My friend texted me and they're like, oh my God, the internet's up in arms about Sonic the Hedgehog and this and that. And I was like, I saw the poster and I was like, you can't even see it.
Right? That's what I'm saying.
You can't even see it. What are you mad about?
We don't even know what he looks like yet.
They're like, oh, it's like weird face. I'm like, you can't see his face at all.
Right.
So like, I get if it's like funny, haha, whatever, but like, it's also, some people are like so mad. And also, it's, I think it's important to say, like, this is not the majority of people. This is like a
very vocal.
Always, but how do they always, the minor, like,
the loudest minor?
Really?
They become huge. It's like, damn.
I think
the biggest thing I saw was he has fur and he has kneecaps.
And
what?
I died too. And from what I understand, he also has two separate eyes rather than the one like white space with with the two eyes in it.
Yeah.
So everybody's just kind of like I'm surprised I haven't seen Not My Sonic tweets.
Yeah.
Yet. You know what I mean? It's like, this is a video game character who hit its peak in popularity 25 years ago. And let's like wait till the movie comes out before you hate it.
Yeah. And also too, you know what Hollywood does. They change it so that another audience can see it. This is what I was complaining about. I was complaining about Ninja Turtles.
Okay.
I was losing my mind about Ninja Turtles and how, like, the first thing that I heard about it was that there were going to be mutants from space and all this stuff. And I was like, I was so mad. And I was like, oh, I can't stand Michael Bay and this and that. And he was like, dude, shut up. The movie hasn't even come out.
Right.
You have no idea. And then he went to see the movie and enjoyed it. I was like, I'm not seeing this trash, blah, blah, blah. He's like, it is not that serious.
Right.
And most importantly, this is not even real. It's not even real.
Right.
So like, so relax. And I'm like, oh my God, you're changing origin stories and backstories and this is what, and he's like, and most importantly, it doesn't belong to you.
Yeah, that's the thing.
Yeah.
Just because you are a fan and you enjoy it doesn't mean that you have some sense of contribution to the content of what you're enjoying.
And so like, so with Sonic, it's like, I'm going to see the movie and if I don't like it, I'll be like, oh, that sucked.
Yeah.
But okay, whatever, moving on. But I feel like there's going to be people who are going to lose their minds and it's like, no, Sonic was made for us back then.
Right.
Now they've got to make Sonic for like a new audience.
A new audience and in a real world.
Yeah. So like, so I'm very curious to see how it looks. So people like take a dump on like Venom when they saw the trailers for it. And I was like, the movie's not even out. Just relax. Just relax.
And like, I was skeptical about it when I saw the trailer. I was like, there are things about it that I'm not super thrilled about. It was a blast. I think you're really going to enjoy it when you do see it. But it was a lot of fun.
I'm pumped to see it.
It was a lot
of
fun.
And I'm pumped.
Yeah.
So I guess the point of what we're saying is just enjoy things. And if you don't enjoy thing A, there's thing B, C, D, E, F. Just enjoy that.
Yeah, you'll find a lot of, there's so much out there to enjoy too. And you're probably going to feel a lot better. I mean, we all catch ourselves being negative.
Yes.
From time to time. But there's so much to enjoy. You'll probably enjoy it even more when you allow yourself to just be positive about stuff.
Just
power positive.
Just hit it like Elsa. Let it go.
Yeah.
Frozen style. Okay. I got to get stuff together for the show.
Yes.
We got to get you out there. Hey, thank you so much for being on.
My pleasure.
Appreciate
it really was an honor to be here. And like, it's, I don't know. I don't know what to say. Just very
pleasure's
grateful.
Pleasure's all mine. Thank you.
Hey, thank you. So I'm just happy to be here.
Where can they find you guys on socials? And like, what are you doing?
Yeah.
Push all your stuff.
At AJ Kirsch on all things social media. You can also follow my doppelganger, Brosif Joe Brody, at Bro J Brody, separate social media. It's more fun that way. And I guess more than anything else, Hood Slam every Friday at the Oakland Metro Opera House, 21 and over. Don't break.
There goes Matthews Flight on Twitter, Mike Matthews on Facebook, Instagram's kind of personal, so don't take offense if you're trying to friend me on that. Same thing, you can see me every third Friday coming up for Hood Slam, and then from there I'll be around in probably your local bar or local BFW, who knows,
right.
Having some fun.
Perfect.
Oh, and also youtube.com/IamAJKirsch. I got an entire series about the behind-the-scenes stories as I did the voiceover motion capture for WWE 2K19. Ooh. I didn't want to let this go without mentioning that. It's called WWE 2K Fabe. Perfect. So youtube.com/IamAJKirsch. I appreciate it.
Links will be in the bottom below. Check them out. Follow them. Show them some love. Appreciate you being on, guys. Tell your friends about this. It's a great, fun episode.
It's a good time. Share good things with good people.
Exactly.
People have personalities, man, outside of what you see.
See,
so, like, this is,
see, they yeah. branch out. They
it's
branch
true.
Out. So always remember to like, subscribe, share, all that good stuff. But most importantly, make sure you always and forever keep it tight. Yes. Oh no, we can't keep it tight yet. You need a nickname.
I need a nickname?
Yeah, it can be AJ Kirsch if you want to. But I'm supposed to ask you if you want a nickname. I completely forgot to do that.
Oh, Buzz.
Buzz. Buzz. Welcome Buzz to the show.
Yeah.
And you need one too.
Woody?
Buzz and
Woody. Ah! Welcome. Yes. I don't know.
You've got it. A friend in me.
Yeah.
Keep it tight.
To infinity and beyond.
Da 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 da